In the Hamiltonian cycle problem, we are given an undirected graph G on a node set V and an edge set E, and we are asking whether there exists a simple cycle in this graph that contains every node of the graph. So an example for a graph that would not contain a Hamiltonian cycle is this. And at first, maybe it's difficult to see that this graph doesn't have a Hamiltonian cycle. But when we think about it for a little bit, we realize that this is a bipartite graph. And the graph has an odd number of nodes. And therefore, it cannot contain a Hamiltonian cycle, because a Hamiltonian cycle would have to alternate between the left side of the graph and the right side of the graph. And it's not possible to do this if the number of nodes is odd. So this is an example where we know there is no Hamiltonian cycle, bipartite graphs with an odd number of nodes. But in general, this can be quite difficult to see. A slightly different problem is the problem of directed Hamiltonian cycle. It has exactly the same definition, except that we now have a directed graph, a digraph, instead of an undirected graph. So the input is a digraph, and the question is if there exists a simple directed cycle in this graph G that contains every node of the graph. We claim that directed Hamiltonian cycle polynomial time cup reduces to undirected Hamiltonian cycle. The reduction is not overly complicated. Clearly, these two problems are very related to one another. One warning, though, one thing that does not work is to simply ignore the edge directions and interpret edges as undirected. For example, we could have a triangle like this, in which the edges are directed, but not in such a way that they form a cycle. And so the directed Hamiltonian cycle problem here would say that there is no directed Hamiltonian cycle. But if you just ignore the edge directions, of course there is a cycle. We can just like cycle through all three nodes of this graph. So how does the reduction work instead? We have a directed graph. Let's focus on a single vertex here. Let's call this vertex V. Vertex V has some incoming edges, say from nodes A, B, and C, and has some outgoing edges, for example, to some nodes D and E. We now transform the graph by replacing such a node V with three nodes. We call them VI, V, and VO. VI stands for input and VO stands for output. And now VI will take all the incoming edges of the node V. So we will connect the outgoing node for vertex A, AO, to VI. And then we go from BO to VI and from CO to VI. Right, remember, we do this for every vertex in the graph. So the vertices A, B, and C also have three copies now. They would have AI, A, and AO, and B would have BI, B, and BO, and so on. For VO, we look at what outgoing edges V has. V has outgoing edges to D and E, so we would connect VO to the incoming nodes for D and E. So we would connect VO to DI and to EI. And then we also connect VI to V and V to VO. And we claim if we do this for all the nodes in the graph, we increase the number of nodes in the graph by a factor of 3. But that's a very small blow up. And I claim that now this new undirected graph has a Hamiltonian cycle, if and only if the original directed graph had a directed Hamiltonian cycle. So the first direction is maybe the easier one. If the original graph had a directed Hamiltonian cycle, then we can easily find an undirected Hamiltonian cycle in the new graph. Say in the directed Hamiltonian cycle, we visit the vertices in some order. Say we visit vertex X, y, and z in that order, and so on. Then in our undirected graph, we would find a Hamiltonian cycle by visiting these vertices in the same order and splicing in these incoming and outgoing vertices on the way. So we would go from x to x outgoing, xo, to y incoming, yi, to y itself, and then to y outgoing, and then to z incoming, and then z outgoing. So you just follow the nodes in the same order, but always go to the incoming node, and then the node itself, and then the outgoing copy of the node. I hope it's clear that this will be a Hamiltonian cycle in this undirected graph, because we visit all of the nodes in a simple cycle. So for the opposite direction, suppose we have a Hamiltonian cycle in this undirected graph, but then we also get a Hamiltonian cycle in the directed graph that is directed in the correct way. And for this, realize that if we have some vertex V here, the only way we can visit V in our Hamiltonian cycle is that we first have Vi and then V and then Vo in the cycle with no other vertex in between, or the other way around. We could go from Vo to V to Vi. I mean, the direction doesn't really matter here. This is because we have to visit vertex V, and to get to vertex V, we have to go through either Vi or Vo. And let's say we go from Vi to V, then there is no way to go back because we cannot use this edge twice. So once we go from Vi to V, the only remaining option is to continue to Vo. So we always have to visit these three nodes in this order. But now if we only look at the blue nodes here, so the original nodes, and visit them in the same order, then that's a directed Hamiltonian cycle in the original graph. This is because to go from some vertex x to some vertex y here, what will have to happen is that we go from x to the output node of x to the input node of y and then to y. But that must mean that there was a directed edge from x to y, because otherwise we would not have connected xo to yi. And so this construction works. If we have a Hamiltonian cycle in this undirected graph, we also had a directed Hamiltonian cycle in the original graph.